Greetings. I was reading in the Quran this morning and came to Sura 71:1. Lo, we sent Noah unto his people, saying, Warn thy people ere the painful doom come unto them. Surely we sent Nuh to his people, saying, Warn your people before there come upon them a painful chastisement. Behold, we sent Noah unto his nation. Warn your people before an awful doom comes to them. Ahmed. We have sent Noah to his people. Warn your people before a painful retribution comes to them. The Progressive Muslim Translation. Verily, we sent Noah unto his people, saying, Warn thy people ere there come unto them torment afflictive. Abdul Majid Translation. And while it seems clear, it really contains a tiger trap of issues. First and foremost, who are Noah's people? You really have two possibilities. Noah's people are either his immediate family or it is his nation. Seems simple enough, right? Sura 71:1 claims that Noah was sent to his people, quote unquote, to warn them. And why the warning? Was it like Jonah sent to Nineveh? Remember the story, God sent Jonah to Nineveh? Whale, belly, all expense paid, two nights stay. God's goal, Nineveh, hear, repent, be saved. Do you imagine that Noah was sent to his people the same way? Hold that thought. The Quran makes another claim in another surah that every nation has had a warner sent to it. Sura 14:4, And we have not sent any messenger except in the language of his people, so that he may clarify to them. But God misguides whom he will, and he guides whom he will, and he is noble and wise, and completely screwed up if you ask me. Sura 10:47, And for every nation there is a messenger, and when their messenger comes on the day of judgment, it will be judged between them fairly, and they will not be wronged. Sura 35:24, Surely we have sent you with the truth as a bearer of good news and a warner, and there is not a people, but a warner has gone among them. It would seem hard to try and deny that according to the Quran, every nation has had a prophet, a warner, a messenger. So was Noah sent as a messenger to his family or to his nation? The only rational and consistent answer is nation. Don't believe me? Well, if you refuse to accept Noah was sent to his nation, you must ask and answer the following question. But remember, this is based on the premise of the Quran's claim of Sura 71:1 that Noah was sent as a warner to his peeps. If you reject Noah was sent to his nation, who was the messenger sent to his nation? Because the record of the events was that Noah and his family were saved. And that would mean unless the warner was one of Noah's family, the warner was not saved. Following so far, that pretty much requires that, yes, Noah was the messenger to his nation and not just his family. Remember, Sura 71:1 says Noah was sent to his people or his nation. And why is that important? Because if, as the Quran claims, Noah was sent as a warner, a messenger, a prophet to his nation, Noah was an epic and abysmal failure. Not one person outside Noah's family, those he was head over, those he had authority over, not one other person outside Noah's family was saved. Allow that to sink in for a moment. Islam retells the story of Noah as if God sent Noah to warn his nation. But that is not what the Torah tells about Noah. The Torah is clear that God told Noah to build an ark just to save his family and the animals. Genesis 6:13, "And God said unto Noah, The end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. And behold, I, even I, do bring a flood of waters upon the earth to destroy all flesh, wherein is the breath of life from under heaven, and everything that is in the earth shall die. But with thee will I establish my covenant, and you shall come into the ark, you and your sons and your wife and your sons' wives with thee." Sounds like God is very clear. I only want to save you and your family. God did not say, "Go preach, that the world may repent and avoid judgment." And why is that important? It is important because the Torah contains one message, and the Quran contains a twisted and screwed up recitation of the same events. The Quran claims that Noah was sent to warn his nation to avoid judgment. What? What's that you say, O Muslim?
Noah was not sent to warn them to avoid judgment.
Oh, please. Get real. For one, if Noah was not sent to his nation, there was no warner sent to his nation, and the Quran is a lie. Secondly, if Noah was sent to his nation, and not one person believed him, Allah's message was an utter and epic failure. But understanding the nature of Islamic rationalization, you still have the Inshallah Jihad. You can cling to the excuse that Allah guided all of Noah's nation to hell. Allah sealed the heart of every last single man, woman, and child and damned them all. At the very same time as Allah required Noah to go and preach and teach his message, completely wasting Noah's time. Can you now see the problems of Surah 71:1? Can you see the problem with Islam's rewrite of the story of Noah? God did not send Noah to his people as a warner. And even as I was creating this presentation, I thought, better go check the whole context of the Bible. So I reread Genesis 6 and 7 and 8. Here are the highlights, if you will. Genesis 6:6, "And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them." I'm not sensing a real forgiving, redeeming tone here. How about you? But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations, and Noah walked with God. There is no hint that I could find in the context of Genesis 6, 7, and 8. Of God having an attitude or plan of, I will send Noah as a warner so that man may repent and be saved. But Islam must try to claim this if it wishes to remain consistent. And when Islam must claim that Noah was sent as a warner to his nation, Islam puts its foot in the trap of claiming an epic and abysmal failure of Allah's message to impress anyone on earth at the time. The Torah tells of God's plan, his judgment, and his salvation for Noah and his family. And Noah was in fact saved along with his family. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith. The Quran, on the other hand, tells of Noah warning his whole nation, and nobody listens. They are all drowned and damned. Only Noah and his family are saved. And you know, now that I think about this some more, there is one more huge ark-sized problem with Islam's claim. Why did Noah build an ark that was only big enough for his family? It took years and years to build the ark. It was built to a plan that he used from when he began to build. He didn't change it. Does it bother you, O Muslim, that by Noah building an ark for only his family, that confirms Noah knew from the beginning of the ark that only his family would be saved? And what excuse could Islam offer to that issue? Oh yeah, each and every man was supposed to build an ark for their family, right? I don't deny that there are many stupid responses Islam could try and give if they ever thought about the contents of the Quran, but I sincerely hope that you have seen enough of this particular foible, error, crazy claim to see just how erroneous it is. Noah was not sent as a warner. Still don't believe me? Do you know how long Noah was building the ark? 120 years. How long did it take Muhammad to form an army and force his religion as a warner? 23 years. And Muhammad was able to convince thousands of followers with no signs and no wonders. Only words. 23 years and Muhammad convinced thousands to fight and die for him. 120 years and Noah did not convince a single person to be saved with him on the ark, let alone die for him in battle. There is simply nothing you can say of Noah as a warner except absolute failure. Or you can be honest and accept the fact that he was not a warner. You can accept the truth, recorded in the Torah, that Noah and his family were saved by God because Noah found grace in God's eyes. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.